Hey guys, Victor here. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'll share four mindsets that I actively use to stay motivated. Coming up. As always, before we kick today's video off, please don't forget to smash that like button because it really helps out in the YouTube algorithms. And if you drop a comment, even better. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Let's get on with tip number one. So the first thing on staying motivated that actually kind of precedes staying motivated is finding your why. And finding your why is not the same thing as setting a goal. Why is more the reasoning behind it, the feeling in your stomach if you were to reach a goal that you're aiming for. So finding why is super important. If you only have a goal and a time frame, that's only 50% of the recipe of actually being able to get there and stay motivated all the way through hardships and whatnot. So an example of that could be that I want to make a lot of money in my life. And the goal is making money. I might even have a set amount of money that I want to be making within a set time frame by the time I'm 40, 50, 60 years old or what have you. However, the why is more important than the what, according to myself. And the why in this case is I want to be able to make money to sustain my future family. I want my kids to go in a nice school. I want us to have several cars if we need to. I want my kids to have nice clothes. I don't want to have a family where we have to argue and fight every month about money and to just have a really nice overall life. I'm not talking about spoiling anyone here, but that's the why for me. Onwards to tip number two. I realized that I'm kind of shooting this as the sun sets, so the lighting in this video is probably gonna be a bit different when we're done with the video from what it is right now. That aside, tip number two is super simple. Don't compare yourself to others. What you do and what you strive to achieve in your life should be because of you, because of what you want and what you want to achieve and your why. It shouldn't be because of anyone else's why or what. In today's society, I think it's really easy, especially in the Western world, with social media kind of bombarding us with pictures of how you should look, what cars you should drive, what clothes you should wear, what vacation you should be going on. But all of that is kind of fake, right? So it's really important that whatever you decide to do in order to stay motivated when setting your goals, when setting your why, etc., is to make sure you're doing it for you and no one else. Onwards to tip number three. I'm always the person to recommend aiming high. My mindset, as shared in one of my previous videos, is aiming for the stars, and worst thing is you'll get on top of a mountain or on top of a tree or whatever. So you should definitely set your aims high. It's like when you're bargaining for something. For example, this guy is trying to sell you something for $100. You want to buy it at 50. You're not going to go up to him and say, I want to buy it at 50, because then you'll end up at 75 or maybe 100. You'll go to him and say, I want to buy it for 10. And probably you'll end up at 40 or 50. So it's the same thing with setting goals. You need to be aiming high to have that margin of maybe not reaching all the way, even if that's the goal and intention. And most of the time you will be reaching all the way because you're awesome. But I think with aiming high, you also need to consider being realistic. So let me get you an example of what I mean by that. As everyone, I know a lot of people who aren't actively working out, but they want to be doing that. They want to get in shape, etc. So what they do is they won't work out for, you know, a year. And then New Year's Eve come and they're like,
yeah, 2019, I'm gonna get fit.
And they start working out 7 times a week. From day one. They don't do anything for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, and then all of a sudden they do it 7 times a week, all in, 110%. And don't get me wrong, I admire that energy, but that's not being realistic. They'll do that for maybe a month, if I'm being generous here. You know, come March, they probably stopped working out altogether. So instead of doing the 110% right now, let's go get it, a realistic approach would be that during 2019, I want to get back in shape if you haven't been working out for a while. And the way you would be doing that is starting out by working out 1 time a week. Then after a month, you're like, I'm doing it 1 time a week. Then increase it to 2 times per week. In a 3-4 months, increase it to 3 times per week. And by the end of 19, you'll be doing the 7 times per week workout, but you went there slowly and progressively. So that's what I mean by being realistic. With that, onwards to tip number four. So when it all comes down to it, tip number four is probably the most important tip at the end of the day, because that's about clearly defining and setting goals. I would definitely not be anywhere close to where I am today with anything in life if I wasn't successful at defining and setting concrete, measurable, attainable goals. So an example for a clearly defined goal, rather than saying,
I want to be rich.
That's a not so clearly defined goal. What you would be saying is, I want to have X amount of money within Z amount of time frame. So I'm 31 today, by the time I'm 40, I want to have $5 million, for example. That's a clearly defined goal. What you then want to do with that goal, because that's such a big, hairy, audacious goal, what you want to be doing with a goal like that is kind of reverse engineer it. So let's call it 10 years. Reverse engineering that, that's $500,000 per year. And $500,000 divided by 12, well, you get the point. That's how much we need to make a month. What do we need to make per week, per day, per hour? And by kind of breaking it down like that, you'd make your goal more bite-sized chunked. And it's easier and more feasible to see here and now, right now, today, what do I have to do in order to reach that goal? Come to think of it, $5 million is probably a pretty stupid idea, because to most people that doesn't make any sense at all. But you get my point. In the next video, I'll talk about how to get to your happy place, micro rewards, and how I use them in my life and what they even are, because I think I came up with that myself. So if you liked today's video, guys, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. It really helps me out. Smash the like and drop a comment. What do you want to see in future videos? What kind of content do you want to have? And yeah, thanks for watching. Have a nice one. Peace.